Okay, looks like this one might be a taker here. And I have good news because I think this one is really going to grow. So, it's supposed to be round, but I don't know, that could change. We'll just see. This is supposed to be a round gourd, a bushel gourd, with a thick shell. These get about the size of a basketball, I think. Or they can get bigger. We'll just see what happens. And I'm going to follow this vine. This is my little patch of watermelon. Wow, it's getting... growing a lot of vines. I don't see any baby melons yet. It's blooming. So, I think I need more flowers around here to draw the bees in. But, here's the other gourd. This is supposed to be a giant gourd. And it's not at the blooming stage yet. So, I'm going to be following the giant gourd too. This is the apple gourd growing really fast. It's already big. It's not finished yet though. It's going to get bigger than this. But the problem I'm seeing is that it's cutting off its nourishment right here. So I'm going to make a little sling for this and hold it so that it won't pinch itself off or break. Okay, I'm making a sling for the gourd using an old sock. And all I'm doing is just cutting it like start at the beginning here to top of the sock and just cut it like that. To make a little sling, and I'm going to tie it, like using these to tie it, and I'll show you what it looks like in just a minute. Okay, you can see where I have tied the sling on there, with enough room to let the gourd grow some more, because it certainly will grow bigger than this. And up here, I've made sure that I cleared that, so that nothing is getting pinched, and it can get the nourishment that it needs. And so this is how it's going to develop and grow, and probably, you know, fill the sock out too. So this is my old sock sling idea. I don't think it's a new idea. but anyway, it works. It works very well.